Hi, I'm Ivan. In my previous video I unboxed the Artillery Sidewinder X2, and here comes the time to mod it. This video is for replacing the stock printhead with the new Voron Stealthburner. The benefits? Lighter direct printhead, better cooling, dual drive extruder and better visual appearance. The standard components of the Artillery X2 allow to implement the internal RGB lighting, and also to keep the existing LED on the toolhead circuit board. Though the stock printhead was performing great, I like the freedom to master any aspect of the printer, and be able to use largely available standard components and hot ends. The Stealthburner is fine for this purpose, and I will be slowly switching to the Voron ecosystem on all my printers, in order to minimize maintenance and cost of spare parts. And, print quality is excellent. My adaptation for the X2 consists in designing a mount for the Stealthburner. It is installed on the stock V-wheels carriage. The original Stealthburner uses inductive probe for ABL, that is not compatible with the X2 glass build platform. That is why I use the stock touch probe. The mount has also additional holes for threaded inserts, allowing you to install other sensors, like BL touch. Here you see it installed on the carriage. If using the stock touch probe, you'll need to extend the wires. All other components are the standard ones and you can download the STLs from Voron's GitHub. Here you'll find also assembly manual and clipper macros for the RGB lighting. The Stealthburner is still in beta at this time, but the mount should be compatible with any version of it. This toolhead allows to install range of modern hot ends, like Dragon, Rapido, E3D Revo and V6 and others. Be careful to print the right mounts for your hot end of choice. Myself, I use a standard V6 hot end, because it is cheap and reliable. Here is the extruder mounted, and here you see how I've got 5 volts power and signal for the RGB LEDs from the original print head circuit board. I did this the dirty way, best would be to solder a connector here. For the PCB holder, I remixed an existing design from Thingiverse. It has a strain relief for the ribbon cable. Here it is in all its beauty. It is possible to control the color of each LED, from the firmware. This could be done in Marlin, however for the ease of use, I switched to Clipper a few years back. On this printer I run Clipper on an old phone with cracked screen, using the OctoPrint port for Android, the Octo 4A app. It runs smooth, and allows me to control the printer both from a PC and from the phone. I'll post my Clipper configuration file on my blog, so if you are interested in this mod, you'll have a good starting point. This setup allows me to use Octolapse with the phone camera for producing HD time lapses. As you see with this frog benchy, the Stealthburner is improving the print quality on the overhangs, because of better part cooling. That's all from me. Please, check the description for additional information, and, see you for my next project.